Nobody knows what's around the corner. Life can be taken away on the turn of a sixpence. But as long as there are people who are prepared to come out of their door every morning and try and help other people, you have got to feel hope.
Hello, Queens. Oh, Jesus.
Adult anatomical.
Been stabbed twice in the chest.
Fall from parachute, hard landing.
Collapse on a football pitch.
Charge to 360.
Yeah, stocking.
Excellent.
Thank you very much. Please call again.
Queen's Medical Centre, Nottingham.
Hey up, Ducker.
Another day in paradise.
One of the busiest A&E departments in Europe.
Wow!
That, I don't think, is survivable.
Have we got a new one coming in?
3 minutes.
There is no room at the inn.
Do you want anything to drink? Cup of tea?
This place is awesome.
A place where life...
Ding, ding.
You're a happy band of people here.
Love.
Love your kids.
And loss.
Can't feel anything.
Unfold every single day.
Working in A&E, you see people in those worst moments of their life.
My baby boy, I can't lose my baby boy.
But there are always stars in the black sky.
Oh, my darling.
It makes you realise how important life is, and we should hang on to that with both hands.
Have you?
Filmed across one 24-hour period, these are the stories of a nation and its health service.
Thank you for everything.
Oh.
Suddenly, a lot of the things that you thought mattered doesn't matter.
It's okay.
But you're there for me and I'm there for you. And that's a strong bond.
I'm loving you too.
Bless you.
Thank you.
I feel like I'm quite an outgoing person. I love meeting new people. Which is why I was so excited for uni and getting to Nottingham. As much as uni is getting your degree, you know, this is an experience that you won't get any other time in your life, and you need to make the most of it. You go out, you fly the nest, you have all these amazing nights out. You're surrounded by friends and you're having a great time. But then one night out could change the rest of your life.
Seen it out there tonight, queuing down the corridor, aren't
they? I'm gonna get an absolutely large Americano.
An absolutely large.
Yeah. Can I just have the machine?
Oh God, I'm so done with this night now.
Hello, Queens.
Oh Jesus.
A female student is being rushed to Queen's Medical Centre after falling unconscious in a nightclub. Her friend was with her at the time.
We'd always go out on a Wednesday. This is definitely the biggest night out in Nottingham. Me and Kate had bumped into each other at various points in the night. I think I saw her on the dance floor, I saw her at the bar once or twice. Just like she was having a good time. At the last point, I suggested getting some food and leaving. As me and Kate were walking down the staircase towards the exit, I'd noticed that Kate had stopped walking. In the space of about 90 seconds, she'd gone from being the Kate that I know and love to on the staircase, her eyes rolled back, her knees buckled, and she fell.
What we got?
She's been found collapsed outside of a club, agonal breathing, due to 3.
Every time she breathed in, it would be like a really sharp, raspy, like, gasp for air. Like, she's just come up from being underwater. Why is my friend on the floor? Why isn't she speaking? Why can't she sit up or stand up?
I am needle, did you say?
Yeah.
Called an ambulance. They asked me to start administering CPR. That was the most worrying part, because you start to think, OK, it's in real trouble here. And if I do something wrong, then potentially looking at a really, really bad outcome for my friend.
Do you need a pap slide, guys?
Everybody ready? On yeah. Three, one, two, three. Lovely. Keep it nice and warm.
Right. So we know this lady's name's Kate. And she's possibly 20 or 21. Approximately 2 o'clock, she came out and walked down the stairs and collapsed. The whole time ago, she's not responding. She's been trying to vomit.
But the minute that you hear that somebody's unresponsive, there is a concern that there is an airway compromise. And there is a risk that they've not got full control over the gag reflex. So instead of actually vomiting it out, there is a chance that it can actually aspirate, which means it'll go into the lungs. And ultimately, if they're not breathing properly, they're going to go into respiratory arrest and cardiac arrest.
Kate?
Kate? Can you give my hand a squeeze? Give my hand a squeeze, darling.
Just open your eyes for me.
She's going to vomit.
All right, my darling.
You sort of replay it all in your mind a lot, especially when it's someone who you care about this much. You look back on it and just think, you know, could I have done anything differently? You know, could I have, like, stopped any of this happening?
Kate?
I could lose my mate.
Kate?
This is BBC Radio 4.
Good morning. Welcome to today's programme. The Home Secretary, Priti Patel, has requested an urgent update from police following multiple reports of women being spiked in clubs in Glasgow and Nottingham. We've also heard troubling stories from young party populations about syringes being used to jab women with drugs to knock them out.
Right, you're all booked in if you want to take a seat. All right, just to let you know, it's a very long wait.
Police are here about a spike. There's loads about it, isn't there? It's been up on radio this morning.
Are you Trent or Union?
Union.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. I'm a Trent.
One of the nurses told me that, like, 6 girls have already been in this morning.
Jesus Christ.
19-year-old Pavni is in A&E after losing her memory on a night out.
I ended up in a taxi on my own with 2 random guys, and that's how I got home, and I don't remember a single thing.
Oh, that's terrifying.
Isn't it?
Pavni? Right, come on in, have a seat.
Thank you.
Right, Pavni, hi, my name is Dimitri, I'm the doctor here. Right, how can I help? What happened?
So I went clubbing on Tuesday night, and it's just a very, like, weird night. Like, it just went, it just wasn't normal at all.
Okay.
I wasn't meant to be drinking much because I had so much work to do the next day, so I didn't drink a lot.
And then what happened?
Well, I got left by my 2 friends, so I was by myself, and then I literally don't remember most of the night at all.
Sure.
Don't remember getting in the house, don't remember getting to bed. And I was like, did I bring someone back? I don't know how I got, I don't know anything.
Do you remember how much you drank? And what kind of drinks did you have?
Vodka, Red Bull.
Okay.
I had 2.
So you had 2 drinks and then you can't remember the rest of the night?
I think the scary part of it all was waking up at, like, 10 a.m. the next day. And I just felt so out of it, like I was, like, shaking. My voice was really trembly, but I felt like I couldn't think properly. Like, I felt like my brain was, like, cotton wool or something.
Any abdo pain?
Yesterday. I forget, it all seems like one day, because I haven't slept. So, yeah, yesterday when I woke up and stuff, I've been feeling so sick. I remember texting my friend and being like, I've never felt like this in my life.
Is there any chance you have been stabbed with a needle?
There was that, and it's, like, raised and stuff, but I don't think it's anything.
What, this one here?
Yeah.
So that was not there before?
Not that I know of.
So what I'm suggesting is we do some blood testing just to check in general, because I don't know if you've been injecting with anything. When someone is spiked, the higher the dose of a foreign chemical into the body, the higher the chance that it will cause toxicity to any of the vital organs. We're looking to rule out any damage to the liver and to the kidneys and making sure that the organs are not failing.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Jane, I'm one of the nurses.
Nice to meet you.
Hello. I'm so sorry to hear what's happened to you.
Yeah, it's just weird.
Did you feel it on the night at any point, anything on your arm? Or was
no,
it just
I didn't
the aching
so.
That you felt afterwards?
It's just aching.
I was really shy, like really, really shy as a child. Timid. Like I would never really say anything to anyone.
So are you at uni at the moment?
Yeah. Second year.
What do you study?
Law.
Oh wow, get you. Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, it's alright, it's alright. I'm missing a tutorial right now, so I'm happy about that.
Ever since I was like really tiny, I've always dreamed of coming to university to come out of my shell a bit more. I thought it would be like all the movies, all the TV shows. I was really excited for it. I remember I had my outfit picked out from the week before. I was like, I hope everyone likes me.
Sorry, I'm just gonna...
No problem. Okay, lovely, sharp scratch.
I grew up in Farnham in Surrey. There's not much to do there. Definitely not as diverse as Nottingham, which is why I really like the change of coming to Nottingham, because I feel like it helped me like understand myself a bit more.
Yeah, it's so strange, it all coming on at the moment.
Yeah.
In primary school especially, I was the only like person of colour there. People would be like, oh my gosh, I bet you smell like curry. I bet your parents own Spice Station, which was this like Indian in Farnham. They were like, bet your parents own that. One time, we all got iPads, and then a boy was like, bet you can't afford that because you're brown. And I was like, okay.
I think some people have been saying in the media, oh, everyone stay safe, but actually, stop injecting people.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Honestly, it's like tips to not get spiked.
Yeah.
Not tips to stop spiking people.
Yeah, absolutely.
I just didn't really relate to anything cultural at all. If you ask anyone at home, they're like, oh, Pavni's like, she's like a white person. I think I distanced myself from it a lot.
Okie dokie. So that's all done.
Thank
yeah,
you.
And it's just a wait to be seen now.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, and the final thing is, don't hesitate to report this to the police
okay.
on 101.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank you.
It's really important that you feel like mm-hmm. you can do that.
Dancing like that?
Strictly
dancing.
Oh, you're
river dancing.
My bum.
Knocking to other people there.
Okay.
So you'll have a scan first, and from there we'll probably have to call the facial doctors.
Is this where I get free plastic surgery?
We'll see. Okay.
Some Kylie Jenner lips, please.
Oh, no.
I made a risotto. I might need to eat it. It's asparagus, tomato, and garlic. It's quite a therapeutic standing there for 40 minutes stirring. Very Buddhist. I quite liked it.
Hello, recess.
Kate, open your eyes for me. You want to try and talk to me?
20-year-old Kate is unresponsive after collapsing in a nightclub.
She's had some ondansetron.
When a patient does collapse and you hear that they have collapsed outside of a nightclub, you automatically do think that either alcohol or drugs are involved. We can give them drugs to reverse it, to help remove the toxin from the system, basically.
Well done, darling. We're going to make you feel better, OK?
But it is important for us to rule out every other option as well.
Do you know where you are, darling? Can you have a guess? Try and say it for me. I know you've probably got a really dry mouth. Hospital, yeah. My name's Grace and I'm the nurse looking after you, OK?
Why am I here?
because you were unconscious. And when you've come to us, you've been very unresponsive, OK? And we've given you some anti-sickness, so that'll start to kick in to take away that vomity feeling. And you're having some fluids, and we've run some blood tests on you.
Is there anyone you want us to call?
Kate really was an outgoing child. I think she's always just been someone who's got kind of like this, like, infectious smile and is just, like, always excited to be with people.
Just doing a tracing of your heart, sweetheart.
Growing up, it was, like, me, my sister, mum, dad. We lived in, like, a little suburban house with, like, a nice garden at the back in Norwich. It's quite a safe place, Norwich. It's nice. Definitely a good place to grow up.
Just keep nice and still a second for me, Kate, so I can get this tracing.
As a little sister, she was annoying a lot of the time, but part of that was because I used to tease her. But in the end, we got along really well.
That's it, darling.
Whenever it snowed, we always used to go out and make, like, the biggest possible snowman we could. We may only be, like, 3 or 4 foot tall, but we need to build, like, a 10-foot snowman. You're going on my shoulders and you're putting the head on. Kate's always loved animals, so she's always wanted to be a vet or work in kind of zoology and that kind of thing. We had a hamster for a couple of years, had a couple of fish for a little while. There was, like, a little duck. I think we called it, like, Curious George. And we'd just go in and we'd just go out and Kate would play with it in the garden.
Have you got any pain anywhere, darling?
My arm hurts, but I don't know why.
We had a really, really good childhood. When our parents got divorced, I think it was just a surprise for both me and my sister. Like, we didn't really see it coming.
Oh, what a wig.
Yeah, I've just asked her if she had any drugs tonight and she went like this.
If a patient has collapsed, it is a bit of a mystery. It has sometimes been a bit like being a detective to try and work out what has caused the collapse.
So it's three needle sticks.
It's terrible.
As if they haven't got enough to be scared about when they go out. And now I've got this.
Is it a clean needle?
Well, that's it, mate. It's just... It's... So there's another girl.
Yeah.
We need to see if she's got a mark on her.
Just double check. Yeah. There's nothing in her arm or anything.
Hey up, babes. What we need to ask you is if you think in any way there's a possibility that you could have had anything injected in your arm at all.
Not anywhere.
Needle stick injuries are absolutely tiny. It's a pinprick, so it can be very, very difficult to try and find where these marks are.
Does anywhere feel a bit sore?
Anywhere at all? Anywhere feel like it stings slightly, or do you remember anywhere stinging or anything suspicious?
I don't know.
I can definitely relate to it because it has happened to me. But not needle form, it's tablet form, and it's an awful, awful experience.
And at the minute, you don't feel you've got anything stinging anywhere. That's us.
It's you.
Yeah.
My finger.
Your finger.
That's the blood sugar. I'm going to have a look at the back of your arms.
Oh, right, sorry, sweetie.
Just lift this arm up for me.
I was at uni and I'd gone out with my brother and a few of his mates and I literally just arrived in the club. I'd ordered one drink, I'd taken a sip from my drink, put it down, took my jacket off, turned back round, picked up my drink, and that is pretty much the last thing I remember.
Show me the back of your arm here, sweetheart.
Do you think you can lift this one up?
Lucky for me, I was out with my brother and he made sure that I got home. Ultimately, anything could have happened and it just goes to show it couldn't happen to anybody. There is a sense of blaming yourself because you do feel like, what did I do wrong? Did I miss something? And people are going to think that you're just irresponsible when you're not. It just happened in a split second.
sounds like they've all been to the same places as you.
Yeah. Who has?
We've just had a few people that have come in and they've been injected and they've all been to the same places where you have.
They've been injected?
Yeah, with we don't know what.
Fuck. Is the nurse going to glue your head, stick it back together?
Yeah!
And do you have to jump around, or do you have to sit really slow? Freeze.
Shall we all see if we can freeze? Ready?
Yeah.
Let's play.
Freeze!
That was perfect.
Now freeze.
I think I've seen three so far, I'm pretty convinced.
Have the police been on it?
Yep. Taking it very seriously.
Clinicians are concerned Kate may have been spiked with a needle and are still searching for a puncture wound.
I'm on a drip and they've been looking for injection marks. I just want a hug.
My name's Gemma, I'm one of the advanced practitioners here in A&E. So, I've got an understanding of what happened, so we'll go through what I know and then you can kind of fill in any gaps for me, but I think you've probably got some gaps in what happened as well, haven't you?
Yeah.
But you start. What do you think, or what have you been told happened and what do you last remember?
I remember two people were carrying me down the stairs.
And you say nothing like this has ever happened before?
No.
The only reason we ask is because it really helps us try to figure out is it just alcohol related?
Yeah.
Or could it be something a little bit more serious that we need to look into a bit more?
I did drink, but it was nothing excessive.
Had you been eating yesterday?
Yeah.
So eating normally?
Yeah, I went out for dinner. It was lovely.
Oh. I mean, that's nice. So you might have heard it on the news is that there is a current kind of spate of things happening across the UK, mm-hmm. but in Nottingham as well. And it's people reporting that they felt like a pinprick, mm-hmm. and then they found like a lump or they might have seen a scratch or something the next day. So the plan is for me to just basically check everywhere on your body because we don't know what happened and we don't know what's been happening with this trend. We don't want to miss that either. So
okay.
We're just going to check things over. Do you mind if I just have a quick look?
Yeah.
There's no bruising or swelling there, is there?
No.
I was 11 and Kate was 8 when our parents got divorced. It's weird to say, but, like, I can't ever remember them arguing.
OK, let's have a good look at your arms. Just arm up for me.
Literally, like, 3 weeks before, we went on, like, quite a nice family holiday to Cyprus, and it was all great. It was all, like, happy families.
Sorry, I'm pretty blood in my pot to give us a clue. Is it all right if I put this over your middle and then you shimmy your trousers down?
Yeah.
It changed our upbringing quite a lot, I think. It forces you to adapt, almost.
I'm just going to take these completely off.
I think Kate held in her emotions about it a little bit. So she became slightly more closed off. It was a difficult time.
I do need to roll you on your side.
Yes.
One of the most common sights we're seeing at the moment is bottom.
Oh,
so I need to
amazing.
Just check there's no marks over your bottom. This is it. I can't see any marks anywhere. And the reason we kind of were thinking of getting a review from the cardiology team, the heart specialist, is because someone who's okay, but then someone collapses, we want to just check that there's nothing from a heart point of view that might have contributed to it. So mm-hmm. we'll have a chat with
Sarah. Hi, Sarah, you all right? Hold on, please.
Student Sarah is also in A&E after suspecting she was spiked with a needle.
My name is Dimitri, I'm the doctor here. What happened?
So I woke up and I saw that and I just don't really know what it is, and like with all of the spikings and injections going on, okay, like I just thought I should get it checked out.
You think you got injected with something?
I mean, it feels like I've had an injection.
Did you go out last night?
Yeah, I was at a club and I was with my friends, and there's like about a 5-hour period that I just don't remember.
You kind of know when you wake up, oh God, I drank way too much. I didn't really get that. I just felt not quite right. And then I felt the bruise on my arm.
Is it painful where I touch here?
Yeah. Not below it, below it there. Just up like that.
How are you feeling yourself now? Is this your normal self?
No, I'm quite like dizzy and I'm a bit nauseous.
Yeah.
And I've noticed that like I'm quite slow, like I'm not as like...
Yeah.
I don't know, like my real, just like this, like I can't really talk very well, like I'm just a bit slow at the moment.
And you don't have any weakness anywhere?
I do feel quite weak.
All over?
Yeah, pretty much, like in my hands and in my legs.
Yeah. Let me just examine you very quickly.
I was born and raised in London. I'm just a big city person. I love being in a place that's always lively and it's always awake.
If you go here.
My parents are quite protective of me, but they trust me and they let me do my own thing. I love having that independence.
Do you smoke?
Occasionally.
Okay, any drugs?
No.
And do you drink every day or
socially? No, like once, no, maybe like 2-3 times a week.
Sure, okay.
Maybe four.
Right. If you rest your legs down.
I was quite tomboyish. I loved football, and I remember for my 8th birthday, I got a Chelsea kit. Lampard was my favourite player, so I got number 8 on the back. I wore it everywhere. Like, I wouldn't wear, like, skirts or dresses. I would always wear my Chelsea kit.
Any tummy pain?
I mean, it's a bit uncomfortable, but it's not, like, painful.
As a kid, I wanted to be an astronaut, and, like, marine biologist, and then I found out how terrifying the ocean was, and I thought, no. But I did kind of want a uni experience, and I did want that higher education.
Right. Okay, so take a deep breath in and out and again.
It was quite a big deal for my mum and my dad, like the last kid like moving out. I was sad to say goodbye to them, but I think that student life, I was really looking forward to that. But then COVID hit and it did change everything.
So this is what I'm suggesting. I suggest we do some blood. Once I have your blood results back, then I'll call you back in to discuss the results.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
No worries, see you later.
I've been invited to a flat party on Wednesday. And you've got to dress up as the first letter of your name. What begins in R? A raccoon? I might go as Jam.
It's Jam? I you know.
Like wear like a hat that looks like a jam jar lid.
All on my mate's heart, that's gonna look sick when it's healed. Yeah, I know. Like Harry Potter. I don't want to go for that look.
I don't actually know if it did happen, but like,
same.
I just want to find out.
Oh, wait, what does yours look like? Because I'm cute.
That's what mine looks like. Because I've got fake tan on.
That looks exactly like the ones in the pictures.
Yeah, exactly.
Pavni? Hi, you're right. Come with me, please. Have a seat. So I have all your blood results back. One possibility is that someone put something in your drinks. The other possibility is that actually you got stabbed with a needle on the arm, exactly where that small wound is.
Could that be something? I wasn't sure if I was just...
Yeah, like... I mean, a stabbing wound with a needle, it would be something very, very small anyway, almost like... Oh, you cannot see with the naked eye.
So I don't know if it is that, then.
Thing is, in Nottingham at the moment, we see
a lot of... That's why my friends are like, you have to go, just in case.
Yeah. We see them almost every day now.
That's horrible.
Yeah. Let's say that you got stabbed with a needle. We don't know that needle, whether it was a dry needle or it was a needle that has some blood in it, mm-hmm. okay? We don't know.
Yeah.
When you're using a needle, you're breaking through the skin. And of course, that is associated with a much higher risk in terms of hepatitis and HIV. So all those things we need to be thinking and trying to eliminate one by one. First course of action is you get an accelerated course of hepatitis B immunization, okay? Where it gets a little bit more complicated is the whole HIV situation, okay? It's difficult because in your case, we don't even know if you got stabbed. But if I do an HIV test on you today, there's no point. The virus will take a few weeks to actually replicate and be detected in a blood sample. Why don't you go outside? I will discuss with a consultant for just a second opinion.
Uh-huh.
And then we make a decision. Spiking makes you feel unsafe. You're meant to be going out with your friends, having fun, having a drink, dance, and all of a sudden you end up in the emergency department with potentially life-threatening situation, organ failures, lifelong infections, which could change your life like that.
In the news, a man has been arrested in Nottinghamshire as police investigate these reports of women being injected.
It's so annoying that we have to be the ones, like, avoiding it. Like, why can't they just do better security?
No, it's ridiculous. Like, we're the ones who have to hide.
Mm-hmm.
So far. I hate being a girl.
Same, honestly.
Doctors are concerned Sarah and Pavni may have been exposed to HIV after being spiked with a needle.
Isn't it weird that yesterday we're like, oh, what do you wear coming? Like, yeah, and now we're like, oh, do I have HIV?
Oh, my God.
Pavni? Have you managed to get anything to eat?
No.
Oh, no.
Starving.
Oh, bless you. All right, how are you with injections? You all right?
I'm all right.
We're giving you a hepatitis B injection.
As long as I don't look, I'm like,
just
all
a little
good.
One. Yeah.
My mum especially is very protective. My mum grew up in India where, like, notoriously it's really hard to, like, go out and stuff without men, like, preying on you.
I was chatting to one of my colleagues out there and it's just the whole thing. It's just so shocking, isn't it?
So weird.
It doesn't make you feel safe going out.
Mm-mm.
I think even that fear is enough to
genuinely
make people stop wanting to, like, enjoy themselves and go out.
My mum was like 13 or 14 and, like, she was just on the bus and some guy just stuck his hand down her top. She turned around and slapped him, but it's the way she was, like, even at the age of 12 or 13, she had to protect herself.
There we go.
My mum had so many bad experiences. I do think she drilled it into me from such a young age that if you're a girl, you can't act the same.
Okie dokie.
As I got older, like, the world gave me more evidence that she was right, and you are treated very unfairly as a woman. It is weird that how much your gender makes you be considered vulnerable, I think.
Now, I had a discussion with the infectious disease consultant. So they actually said the risk of you contracting HIV in the community in that kind of way is so small.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That they now don't recommend taking the medication.
Okay.
So I'm not gonna prescribe it for you. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's very unlikely.
It's very, very unlikely. Thing is, with HIV, if it gets exposed in oxygen and air, it kind of doesn't survive that.
Okay.
If you experience any symptoms, any night sweats, any fevers, become unwell in any sort of way in the next few days, then come back.
Okay.
All right? It's very unlikely. Excellent. Any questions?
Thank
you. No worries.
Do I need to contact the police? I didn't have to.
I mean, in the end of the day, it is a crime, so it should be reported to the police, because if they're getting a number of phone calls for a specific club that this is happening, they might just put some restrictions or some kind of measures. So I guess for those kind of reasons, it makes sense to report it.
Okay.
Okay. Excellent. Lovely meeting you.
Lovely to meet you. Thank you so much.
No problem. All the best.
Thank you. Bye.
A person who goes out with a needle and stabs someone with an unknown substance is something that is avoidable. It shouldn't be happening. It is sad, as human beings and as co-citizens in this city, we have the need to go and inflict harm to another person.
I think basically I can just leave now. So, do you have Snapchat? Because then I want to see if you're okay.
Yeah, definitely. You too. So you're finally released.
Yes.
Go get some food.
I can't wait. There you go. I hope you're okay.
It does worry me, like, how normal it is to, like, come into danger on nights out. It's really, like, disheartening thinking about how evil people can be. It just makes you feel quite powerless.
Sarah?
Yeah, hi.
Hello. So you just waited for an injection, aren't you?
Yeah, and some blood test results, I think.
Right. Dimitri, the doctor that saw you originally,
yeah.
He's going to come back and chat to you after this.
OK.
How are you with needles?
I mean, I don't love them, but, I mean, it's fine.
But you're
I'm fine
okay.
with them.
I'm sure you've had vaccines before.
Yeah, I've recently had double vaccinated.
OK.
COVID was really disruptive for the uni experience. It was just kind of isolating, like, you couldn't chat to anybody, you couldn't make friends. You were kind of only really allowed to be with the people who were in your flat. It was towards the end of first year that everything started to open up a little bit before going out. We were all really excited because it was so new to us. And we'd be like, oh my God, what's it going to be like? We'd all wear dresses and heels, and then we would regret the heels and then regret the dress when it was really cold at night. But yeah, we would always get really excited.
What happened then?
Well, I think I was spiked.
I honestly just cannot believe that people are going around doing this now.
Yeah.
Why? Right, so if you drop your shoulder down, relax your arm.
Having your drink spiked was enough to worry about as it is. But now we had to worry about, like, someone actually piercing our skin with something. It just feels like such a violation, and it's just horrible to have to think about.
Well done.
Actually, wasn't bad at all.
Good. That's the end of your torture for today, then, eh?
I hope so.
I would like to be able to go on a night out and not have to worry about anything, just have a good time and not have anything, like, in the back of your mind worrying about something.
Hey, Sarah, you all right?
Yeah,
hi.
I'm good.
How are you feeling?
Tired.
It's been a long time, isn't it? God, you spent your whole day here.
Yeah.
Right.
Did the test, like, show anything?
The blood is just to make sure that essentially the substance that you might have been injecting with didn't cause any injuries to any organs in the liver, the kidneys, etc. So all your bloods are normal, so have no concerns.
Okay, good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, sorry for keeping you waiting. Do you have any questions?
No,
no?
I don't
you happy?
Think so.
Right, go and enjoy your evening then.
Oh, thank you so
right.
much.
All the best.
Thank you.
No
take
worries.
Care. Bye. All done. All finished.
Oh, my
God. You can move now. Which colour teddy bear would you like?
No.
Which one? This one. There we go. And then you guys are good to go.
Yeah, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Sleeping Beauty, I didn't want to wake you up. Spilling your pulse.
Kate's heart rate is being monitored after doctors suspected she was spiked in a nightclub.
Heart rate's a little fast.
Yeah.
Does it feel like it's pounding?
Yeah.
It doesn't feel overly strong, but it does feel too fast.
It feels fast in my chest.
Does it?
Do you feel like it's like palpitations or anything? Yeah, it just feels like it's like...
Yeah, beating too fast.
Yeah.
So it's about 110. I'd like it to be more sort of 70, 80.
OK.
I think the events of the night, whatever they may have been,
yeah,
have just caused your heart to go a bit fast.
Clinicians have ordered an X-ray to check for any injuries to Kate's chest.
My name is Lina, I'm the radiographer taking your X-rays today.
Mm-hmm. I think Kate wanted to kind of get away from Norwich and see something a bit different, definitely.
I'm going to raise this up and sit you up.
She was really excited to go to uni. We went on all the open days together to different places. She ended up in Nottingham. It was a big deal. Like, she always loved, like, animals, and it was great that she kind of got the place on zoology to be able to do something that she actually really enjoyed.
I'll position this, ask you to take a deep breath in. You breathe in, not now, I'll tell you when. You breathe in, hold it, breathe out, and we are finished.
Okay.
It was nice to see her in, like, a different environment, getting on well and being able to look after herself properly and just enjoying, like, life, really.
We're all finished.
Oh, really good.
Yeah, so you lean forward. I told you less than 3 minutes and we're done.
When she rang and said she'd been spiked, and I was just like, Kate, that's really bad. It's insane that somebody's tried to do that. I think that is... serious intent there to harm somebody.
So we can't find anything on the ECG that seems fine. All your blood tests I've looked at shows a raise in alcohol level, which we knew about anyway,
yeah,
but everything else is completely normal and fine.
Okay.
But because when we had a chat about what happened, there was just these really clear blanks in your memory that, yeah, given you can't remember the CPR either,
yeah,
it just gives us a little bit of a concern. So we want to just keep an eye on you just for 24 hours, just to make sure that nothing else changes in the meantime and that you don't, something doesn't declare itself that might be a problem.
Okay.
Spiking can have an emotional effect.
I didn't really want to go out much after that, after it happened to me.
Most of the people that we are seeing are students, and they have just left home, moved to a new city, just finding their feet, finding the freedom, trying to work out who they are and who they're going to be as adults. And you've got a small group of people who are taking advantage of that.
Just terrifying to think that there are so many possible things that could have happened if my friends weren't there, and I'm so grateful that they were.
It wasn't the spiking really that affected me, it was the uncertainty of what had happened. Like, someone's taken away your ability to remember things. It's not fair at all.
I definitely go out a lot less. It was quite distracting. I couldn't really focus very much on my uni work.
I don't think I've heard back yet.
I do sometimes worry about getting spiked again, but I'm not going to let it stop me from going out and living.
Because I study law, I was actually thinking maybe going into human rights or something, because it's made me more passionate about injustices that face women. I think I can't look at the world through, like, rose-tinted glasses all the time.
It's scary to think that if Harrison wasn't there, would there have been someone else, and what would have happened then? couple of weeks after. And I remember, you know, going out for the first time and realising, like, just how much it did affect me. I remember there was one point where I just stood in a corner, so I had walls surrounding me, so I knew that no one could be behind me. It was not a nice feeling. I felt so uncomfortable and not, like, safe in my own skin. And I just cried loads. I just let it all out. I think it was the first time I'd actually cried or been upset since it happened. It took me a while to get back to normal, really, but I think it is something that you can't let affect you.
Support information for the issues raised can be found online at channel4.com/support. Healthcare and hauntings next. There's ghostly goings on down Seaward, last in the series, Belfast Midwives.